In this video, I would like to talk about another data structure called a list. A list looks kind of like a vector, but the main difference is a list is composed of different data types. If you remember about the vector, vector can contain only the same data of the same data types. Okay. So remember this, a list can take an order the set of values of different data types, okay? So that is the main difference. Otherwise, actually about the same, all right? So let's take a look. To create a list, well, what else? You need a function called the list. So as usual, if you know more about the details about the list, all you have to do is go to the help, question mark, and list. And then you can find all those details about the list. Okay, so let's do that. So list, we have many elements. We could have many elements. And as I just said, a list can contain data from the different data types. Okay, how about character A and numerical value 23. And logical value true. Okay. All right. So we just created a list. And let's take a look. So, and you notice, you know, the way they show a list looks kind of different from a vector, right? So as you can see over here, they use two brackets. Okay. So the first one shows the first element, okay, and this one the second element and the third element, okay. So also you can check how many elements there. So let's take a look. So it should be 1, 2, 3, okay. So let's do that. So 3, no question about that. And also you can check the data type, okay. So what else? List. Okay. In this case, each element has only one value, but actually we can have many values for each element. Okay. So first element is 1 through 5. Can you see that colon? So this means 1 through 5, like 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then the second element is a vector of A and B. Okay, so let's create that. Okay, so why? So we have the first element is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the second element of a Y list is A and B. Okay, and the length is obviously 2, and you know, 2, the first element, second element. Okay, and you wanna check the data type? Of course, we can do that. Is a list. All right, so let's look at another example. So let's create two vectors. So E1, we create a vector E1 having the values of 1, 2, 3, okay, and then E2, and we have another vector composed of character values A, B, and C, okay, and then we can combine those two elements in a list, and then assign that to Z. Okay, so let's take a look. So we just created a vector E1, another vector E2, and then we create a list combining E1 and E2. Okay, and if you look at the value, so first element and the second element, okay, and the first element has a 1, 2, 3, and the second element has A, B, C. So obviously two different data types, okay? So first element has a data type of numeric, second element has a data type of a character. And if you check how many items, how many elements are there? Two, all right? In a list, you can actually give a unique name to each element, okay? So let me give an example here. Okay, so we're gonna create a list like a student. All right, so we are creating a vector. So name the first element we give a name, let's say name, okay? So we have Adam Smith and Beverly Johnson, okay? And the second element, instead of just using a second element, we give a name like age, okay? And then the vector of 34 and 22, okay? And the student status, false. So Adam Smith is not a student, and Beverly Johnson is a student, okay? So let's create a student list, okay? And then if you wanna get the first one, just like a vector, you can use a index value. And as you may remember, in R, index values start from 1, okay? So, so the first element is Adam Smith and Beverly Johnson, okay? But this time, since we gave the name for each element, we can actually access the data using those names, okay? And to access those names in R, you use a dollar sign. You use a dollar sign, which is a little annoying. In most other computer languages, they could use a dot, but in R, you use dollar sign. So you better get used to it, okay? So student, dollar sign, name. So we have Adam Smith and Beverly Johnson. So basically the same. This time you show the location, and this one you show the actual name, okay? So you can look at the age, okay, student, dollar sign age. So you have a 34 and 22, okay? 32 and 24. Or you can just also give a all the names. You can get all the names in the student list, okay? Okay, like name, age, and student status. All right?